There's something out there, you know. Something under that sand. According to one of the best movies of all time, it's probably a mummy. Hey guys, Julia here for D News. Can you believe we've never talked about mummies before on D News? They're like one of the gateway drugs to science. The practice of preserving the dead probably arose accidentally. Burying the dead in a pit of sand where it's dry might make a mummy. It's easy to imagine how a body preserved in an almost lifelike state became spiritually significant. I mean, many religions consider the incorrigibility of the body to be a spiritual sign. Mummies first fascinated the public in the early 1900s, when people would unwrap them in public performances. Dr. Kathleen Shepard from the Missouri University of Science and Technology says these events were poised between spectacle and science. It's kind of a morbid fascination, but we can learn so much from mummies, like spiritual practices of an ancient culture, or even what people ate thousands of years ago. The most famous, or maybe infamous, is the ancient Egyptian mummification process, which dates back to about 3400 BCE. We all learned about this when we were kids. This process removes all the moisture from the body, kind of like turning a grape into a raisin. After removing the internal organs, the bodies are dried out using natron, which is made up of soda ash and baking soda. After being cleaned, the bodies are wrapped in linen and coated in resin. This whole process, including building a sarcophagus or other tomb things, were pretty expensive, so it was usually reserved for the higher-ups or wealthy. But ancient Egypt isn't the only culture to practice preserving their dead. The oldest mummies on Earth are from the Chinchorro culture in South America and date back nearly 2,000 years before the Egyptians. In preparation for burial, bodies were stripped of all their soft tissues, then the skin was stuffed with vegetable matter. Finally, the whole body was covered in clay. But these mummies are in danger from degradation from climate change. The part of Chile where these bodies are kept is notoriously dry, like hasn't seen a drop of rain in hundreds of years dry. Yet, maybe due to change in climate, there's an uptick of moisture in the air that makes the mummy's skin fertile breeding ground for hungry bacteria. Some of these mummies are turning into black ooze. God, that's so cool. Gross. I mean, it's totally gross. Other mummies include some found in the Canary Islands, which were preserved using a method similar to the Egyptian process, but rather than linen, the Guanche people used animal hides to wrap the body. Some Buddhist monks in China practice a form of self-mummification. The process starts when the monk lives on a diet of nuts, seeds, and water for about 1,000 days. Afterwards, the monk basically buries himself alive in a small burial chamber and chants. He would have a small bell to ring to let people know he was still alive. When the bell stopped ringing, the chamber would be completely sealed. After 3 years, the chamber would be reopened to see how preserved the body was. If it was well preserved, it would then be placed in shrines and worshipped. Italian monks in the 16th and 17th century mummified their fellow monks by embalming them and dehydrating them on ceramic pipes. The Capuchin catacombs of Palermo hold over 8,000 bodies, including some wealthy and famous people of the time, some of which are eerily well preserved. So basically, we're surrounded by mummies. Does that give you the chills, the creeps? Got any questions? Let us know in the comments below. While you're at it, hit those like and subscribe buttons and keep coming back for more D News every day of the week.